Hey mamas, it's your Cajun stork here, Midwife Kira. I'm here to talk to you a little bit about 5 non-scary birth facts about your upcoming birth. If you like what you see and you follow us every Midwife Monday, please don't forget to click that subscribe button. Number 1 is pooping on the table. I did an interview with Stephanie Trosclair from Rocka Birth Lamas here in Acadiana, and she said that when she asked her mamas what their biggest fears about childbirth are, the number 1 fear is pooping on the table. And look, I need to be honest with you. Poop happens, but it's also very rare in an unmedicated birth. So one of the early signs of labor is that you're gonna start to empty your bowels out to make room for the baby to come down into your pelvis. As you're going through the birth process, you might even continue to empty out, but when it comes to pushing, at this point, the bowels are typically empty. If we have to deal with poop, it's usually just very little, wipe it away. It's not what women are afraid of about full-on bowel movements on the table. This just does not happen in a truly natural experience. And so I really want you to put the pooping on the table thing out of your mind if you're planning an unmedicated birth. Non-scary birth fact number 2, your water breaking in public. The evidence says between 11 to 30% of women's water breaks before the onset of labor. But typically, in both my experience and the experience of other healthcare providers that I surveyed to make this video, we all pretty much agree that it's very rare that your water would break in a public situation. Most of our mamas have their water break while they're in home, in the middle of the night or in the middle of the day. Please tell us in the comments below where you were when your water broke, because although I know it does happen, I do want you guys to know that it's actually pretty rare to have it happen in a public setting. So you have no control over this. Stressing over when and where and how your water's gonna break is not something worth your energy. It just is what it is. Scary birth fact number 3. Now, if you watch my videos every Midwife Monday, you've probably seen me talk about vaginal tearing. If not, I want you to go ahead and watch this video. I'm gonna post the link to it in the comments below. But basically, for vaginal tearing, a lot of women are afraid of how much pain it's gonna cause. And so they decide and opt for epidurals earlier in their labors because they don't wanna feel that last couple of seconds of pushing. Mamas, the ring of fire is the only time that pushing really hurts per se, and it is literally a second or two of your life. So don't be afraid about vaginal tearing during pushing, and especially, I would really discourage you to opt for an epidural for pain management prior to this, just for this 1 or 2 seconds of your life. You've got this, you can do this. So non-scary birth fact number 4 is delivering the baby in the car on the way to the hospital or birth center. In my practice, I have a different perspective on this than probably your healthcare provider does. In my experience, birth is typically a very normal, natural experience because my mamas are healthy, they're low risk, their babies are termed, they're head down, so we know everything's going well. And so if my mamas are worried about delivering their baby on the way to the birth house, I just teach them how to catch the baby. I mean, birth is one of the most natural things that our body can go through. Ask your healthcare provider to teach you a little bit about emergency childbirth, because being prepared will take the fear out of the accidental car delivery. Non-scary birth fact number 5. I cannot tell you how many times I get asked as a midwife delivering babies in a birth center about what do I do in the instance of cord entanglement. What this means is if the cord is wrapped around the baby's neck. Let me start off by telling you that one of the first births I attended as an apprentice, this baby was wrapped around the neck, over and under each arm like a little backpack, down the leg and around the leg. This cord was completely entangled. And this midwife handled it so gracefully. She just unwrapped the baby and handed the baby over to the mother. It was no big deal. Evidence says that cords are wrapped around the baby's neck 1/3 of the time, and most of the time they do not actually impede with labor. And so these shows that really blow up these moms who've delivered their babies at home on accident, and oh my God, the cord was wrapped around the baby's neck. You guys, this is really not a big deal. Just untangle it. Most babies are doing fine. Cords around the neck are a variation of normal. It's nothing to be afraid of. If you have any non-scary birth facts you think that I should have added to this video, post them below. I'll make another video on this for you ladies. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next Midwife Monday. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you can keep up with all of our videos. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.